Srinivas from Seventh Sense Trainer for today's session. Like we today we have a new topic to cover, a new soft skill topic. Today's topic is innovation. Like, what do you guys understand by this particular term, innovation, or being being innovative or creative? What does it mean, the term innovation? What is your understanding regarding the term innovation? According to you, what is your understanding about the particular term? What is your understanding? What do you call an innovation according to you? I'm hoping for some response. Though it might be wrong, no issues. Come up with some definition, so that, or not a precise definition, I want just what is your understanding regarding the particular term innovation. What do you think innovation is? Is it so required in our day-to-day life, or is it not so required, or is it essential to inculcate those set of skills in us to develop? How is it? Innovation is nothing but bringing out a better way and bringing out the best by using our thinking, our creativity. That is the one thing that we should be having from our end. When that is what it refers as innovation. Why innovation is important? Why it is important? Why? Anyone? Why do you think innovation is really important in everyone's life? Like, if you are really creative, if you have those creative set of ideas, you are the guy who can change, you are the person that who can change the entire society for and uplift the living. Like, for society, you can be an who can bank on, because you are having certain creativity skills that others, it will help the whole society. Just look at this picture representation of this particular slide. Here you can see that some of them are using the umbrella for the purpose of just saving from the rain. But the other guy who had some creativity uses the same to float as well as to take the production from the rain. This is what it refers, being innovative and being creative, having those set of creative ideas and implementing those to the particular situation according to the requirement is known as innovation. Like Thomas Alva Edison said that there is a way to do it better. Find it. What does it mean? Finding it. How we can find that? Is it so easy task or very difficult one? What do you mean by that? There is a way to do it better. But here it is not precisely mentioned which is yes or no. Let us take an example for this. There is always a way for each and every thing or step that we take up in our every life, right? It might be related to academics or to our career. There will be definitely a better way, right? You could have thought, you could have been creative sometimes. That is what Thomas Edison said. There is a way to do everything in a better fashion way, that we need to find it by our end. That is called as innovation. And let's go jump into the like more precise, more apt, more better definition, so that you can get the best out of that. What is innovation? How innovation can be brought up? Is it so easy thing, or it can be done by each and everyone? How is it? What do you think? Innovation is a very easy task that can be performed by all of us. Or how does it mean? As I said earlier, innovation is a way to do it in a better way. For finding out that particular way is known as innovation. It's a new way of doing something, like a different or a unique. That is what it refers as innovation or innovative. But why it is required? Do you think innovation or innovative is required? Or it is not so required in our day-to-day life? What do you think? Is it so required? Is it so required? There will be an incremental and emergent of revolutionary changes in thinking and the process that are brought up by every organization. Why they will be revolutionizing their products? What is the need of that? What is the need to revolutionize the products? Why it is required? Or for the betterment of living, right? For the betterment of us. For betterment of the whole mankind, innovation is very necessary. So, you know, given the utmost importance, and while doing any innovation, you should be having some creative ideas. But when you are looking into those creative ideas, obviously there will be some failures. Sometimes you might not get the desired result. Like Thomas Edison had an innovative idea to bring up a bulb. Yes or no? Thought about that, right? I want to bring up like a source which can give a light so that we can work even in the night times or after sunset. We had that creativity, but he failed several times. There were failures on the path that he walked on a daily basis. Like he failed more than multiple times, but he did not give up. That is the most important thing. You should be having creativity as in a very easy way. That is the thing that we should inculcate. If you are dreaming, if you are having some creative ideas, not enough, having the attitude of being accepting the failures and looking into the how we can do better. That is innovation or innovative. And coming to what is innovation arise? What does it give at the end? They are like each and everyone will be like someone or some organization is coming up with some innovative ideas. What will be the end result of that? What is the end result? And if an entrepreneur, is the one who thinks in an innovative as well as you'll be having his own creativity. Yes or no? Then only you can become an entrepreneur when you are not having that particular innovative as well as the creative skills and you are not knowing how to accept your failure. That's not the way that you can develop a new product, right? When you're not having those set of skills, you cannot do this. As well as when you look in the other way, when it comes to innovation, when you work on that, definitely we'll come up with a new product, right? Because of the new ideas that we have implemented. And it will be a new process, right? When you are developing a new product, let us take an example for this. All of you are knowing about the automobile sector. Yes or no? Like they came up with, there are always coming up with some with innovatives, right? They will bring up a new product. Like when you compare the previous, like the last decade, there was a search for an SUV, like the premium SUV. There was an open market, but the organizations were coming up with some innovative ideas. But Toyota capitalized on that in a very innovative and creative ideas. It brought up Toyota Fortuner. That was a new launch in 2009, if I'm not wrong. It was launched in 2009. It had better ground clearance, better features. Airbags was implemented in the first stage itself. Like it had the new product that was not provided by any other by competitors. That was the one thing. And for the same process, if you want to improve, want to bring up a new product. And it became a new market, captured the market. Business. They were capitalized by that. Having those innovative set of ideas and being creative is really important. What is innovation? What is innovation? What is innovation? What is innovation? And coming back to, there will be like, why it is required in order to, in a point of an organization view, like innovation increases the profits. How it will increase the profit? How it will increase the profit of any organization? How is it possible? Is it possible to increase the profit of any organization by having some innovative ideas? Or being or coming up with some unique set of new creative thoughts? It will be definitely be an yes. And innovation can increase the profits. How? As we can take an example of any production-related organization itself. I took an example of Toyota. Like it came up with the Toyota Fortuner, which was a premium SUV. Like in the past 10 decades, when you think of the, like not the 10 decades, in the past one decade, it was the most innovative idea that was bought by Toyota. They came into the particular sector with Toyota Fortuner, which was the most premium SUV with better ground clearance, with improved safety, and they provided the best in class features. Based on the value side, the customers valued your innovation and the thoughts and the design process as well, and the overall sales of that particular margin increased. It increased a lot. Like it like the sales figure, like oh, if Toyota had around 20, like it increased, it really boosted the sales figure of Toyota nearly 50%. Like the overall. Still, it is a major selling SUV for Toyota. It's like a good, it's like a big name for, like the Toyota itself is made for Fortuner. That is the name because of the innovation, right? If they are not having that innovative or creative skills, was it possible? No, right? And would they have gained some profit? It would be an absolutely no. And or the cost side, and the company offers producers the offering in a more efficient way. Did they provide the more effective way? Did they provide? Obviously, it is an yes. Why? Because it provided the best-in-class features, best-in-class, what you can say, the more added feature that was not provided by anyone till then. And the customers liked that. And in turn, when the customers liked both as a cost side and as well as when they are providing the best-in-class features, innovation will make sure that the whole organization profits will be more, sales figure will be more, targets will be achieved. That is why innovation plays a damn important role. Doubts till now? And yeah, any doubts? So that we can make it really clear. Very easy topic. We just focus on that. You can improve in a daily basis, on a daily basis, on for your career as well. And we'll jump into the next thing, like coming to the between innovation and being invented, or what we call invention. What is the difference? If someone is saying that I am having some innovative ideas, and someone says, if one of your friends is saying, I am trying to invent or trying to do some research, what does it mean? Invention and invent. What is the difference? What is the difference? What do you think the difference might be according to the, but just looking into this pictorial representation, what might be that? What do you think it might be? It is a very easy one. Invention is nothing but the thing that will be for first time bought in society, first time done by anyone till now. That is what is called invention. The bulb and the updated features like the CFL, CFCs, are those are the innovations that were done on the same ideas, but there was an increased efficiency, effective, longer life. All those things come into place in the innovation or the innovative or being creative. In the invention, it will be the first time that was brought, first time something has been done. As this is a bicycle, an example, and this is an bicycle used by an athlete for the races. That is an innovation from our end, like over a period of time. But sometimes inventions might be like not so effective. It might be like when they take up the example of bicycle, it was very effective at that particular point of time to commute from one place to other, right? And in the same way, it depends upon how we innovate, how we bring up the new process, new designs. That is the thing. This is the difference. Invention is nothing but which will be brought out for the first time, and innovation by using or implementing our creative ideas will be trying to bring out the best, better one, more efficient one, with a longer life, with a better cost. That will be innovation. Any doubts regarding the term innovation and invention? Any doubts till now? We'll jump into the next thing. Yeah, as I said earlier, an invention is different from innovation at any particular point of time, because when you take up an example of a bicycle itself, which was invented earlier, like in the earlier era, around some AD and all, but at that particular point of time, it was not having any commercial value, but sometimes it might have in the future. Is it yes or no? Like earlier, they developed the automobiles which were not so fuel efficient, the earlier eras, but now the automobile sector as being a commercial sector where your profit margin is really good, that might be because of innovation. That is a difference. But when you are doing any invention at that particular point, you never know whether it can being a commercial value, whether it might increase in the future, or it'll be of really importance when you jump into the future. You cannot decide that now. And there will be no, like, inventions can be done. Inventions are being done in each and every domain. Like, they are inventing products which are more efficient. Now, look, we are not inventing products. We are innovating products. Like, inventions are things that will be done for the first and the foremost time. But when you are developing an invention, there will be, like, a really challenging task is to sustain that particular product in the market. Sometimes some innovations might never come to the use of the whole world. Like, they might be not liking that. That's the way. Any doubts? But when the invention is being done and by using our creative ideas, we can make it more efficient.
That is what it would call as innovation. And the innovation is an interplay where a product will be developed with better technology than the previous days. Yes or no? Like, would you like to use the same product and you can say, or would you like to say it has a new innovation? No, right? You would obviously want a product with more technology, and the product should be having, will be like people friendly. Then only it can be called as an innovation, right? When you take an example of the mobile or a cell phone itself, it is an innovation, right? Like in the earlier, they had developed the phone where we could have called, we could have sent some messages, but later on, we got the better version of that. That's an innovation where they had implemented the new technology for the betterment of the whole society. And now, it has really benefited a lot of people. That is what it refers as innovation. Like bringing in the new technologies, implementing that for the betterment. And coming to back, it provides, because innovation is like when you are, like when you take an example of any organization, when they are innovating, obviously they will look into producing the best products at a really affordable price, right? Can any organization can come up with a mobile phone and say that it is like 10 lakhs? No one had come up, like comfortable to buy that, right? So innovation will be done in such a way that the product would be at a really lower cost. It will provide a higher standard of living. How? Like each and everyone are now able to use browse. If they are having a smartphone, they can access the information that they can. They will be getting it in very, in the at their fingertips. Listen, that is an added advantage because of the innovations. Yes or no? Like, how can we innovate, or how can we implement some innovative ideas to your day-to-day life, like to your academics? Do you feel like your academics is really tough? Anyone here? Was really difficult to cope up with? Have you done any creative, or brought up, or have I had a thought that I need to be more creative, I need to think something that will be really easy for me to understand those set of topics or to deal with the examinations? Anyone had thought that I need to have some creative ideas from my end? Did you have that thought, anyone, till now? That I need to come up with some creative ideas, or I need to do some inventions, or like not some inventions, like having some weird thoughts that how can I simplify my studies? How can I cope up with that in a very easy fashion? Anyone had that attitude? Like I want to take some innovative steps that no one has done till now. I'll give a small example for this. Like all of you find it really difficult, right? When you are which is a difficult subject. Let us take an example like universal. Like all of us say that mathematics might be the difficult part for most of us. How can we take some innovative ideas there? How can we make it simpler for us, for our betterment? How can we do that? How can we get simplified? How can we simplify that so that we can get the best result at the end? What is the thing that we need to inculcate from our end? I will give a very small, mind mapping is the best technique where you can develop a map that is an innovative idea, but you should inculcate. It will be really efficient and it will definitely give a boost of nearly, what I can say, bare minimum of 5 to 10%, because in the mind mapping, if you're taking up a particular subject or any domain, or if you are having a goal or like anything, but we'll make it very simpler so that you get the best. Like In the mind mapping, we'll take an example of mathematics, engineering mathematics. Let us take an example, very as you are in engineering itself. We'll take that as the main thing that is very difficult. We will do, we'll take some innovative steps. What I will do is like, I will take engineering mathematics. I will take a look of the syllabus. And then I'll come to know that there are some calculus is really difficult for me. I will make it a separate part. Then I'll come into the some of the most easier part. 60% of it is for really easy for me. And the rest 40% is the calculus part. I will make sure that the 60% what is really damn easy. I will make a mark or what I can say. I will make a note of all the important topics. Like after I get around 20 important formulas. Let us say take an example itself. 20 formulas we are taking as an example. I will make it in a, I will write it in a sheet of paper and will paste it to a wall or to my where I go to study table, near my study table. I will paste it there. And in that most in those 20 formulas, I will look at the previous question paper and I'll come to know that by just looking into the 10 important formulas that are really important, I can get nearly 40% of the marks. 40% more than passing marks. I will make the list of those. I will write that on a sheet of paper in an inverted way, not the straight one. So that whenever I have a look at that, I need to turn my head or I need to turn the sheet itself. That is an innovative idea from my end. You can take some instances or examples from your end. You can, what you can do if you want to be like innovative, you can use the glitter sheets to highlight that or can use some other, what you can say, crayons. Some innovative things that you like, but I prefer writing the entire formula upside down. It is an innovative idea from me. Just give an example so that you can implement. When I do that, obviously when I get into my room or to my study table, obviously on a daily basis I will have a look, right? I will not forget those formulas, and it will be really be helpful for me at the when I am preparing for the examination, because I'll be having a thought that I had implemented this really innovative idea from my end, and I have really good idea about what are the most important formulas that I need to memorize that I'm having. Yes or no? And it will give a self-confidence boost, and already you are having an attitude that I have already 40% of the marks in my pocket. That is an innovative idea that you can develop for your academic career. Very simple one, right? Or it's really difficult just to make at least the notes of the more 20 more important formulas and the 10 looking into the previous year question paper, analyzing that and making a note of the rest. Or as 10 important formulas, either so difficult, it will be like very easy, right? It is an innovative step from your end. Is it yes or no? It can't be innovative. Is it yes or no, guys? Come on. Very easy, very simple, right? That is why innovations or being innovative or being creative is really important. And coming back, there are types of innovation. Innovation cannot be the same, right? Like there will be innovation for the products that we have, process, service information. What do you mean by product, service or process innovation? What do you understand by that? The product innovation. Like earlier, you were using this, what you can say, a candle. Then, because of the efforts, because of the invention, we came all the way. We produced electricity. We got an effective way how to deal with that particular source. And then this is the, like till this, it is an invention. Then comes up our innovative ideas. We produce the CFLs, CFCs, LEDs, light emitting diode. Yes or no? Like, but it was not achieved. Like in a span of 2 years only, right? It took time. Why? Why it took time? Why it takes time when you are having some innovative ideas to implement that? Because when you are having some innovative ideas, it's not so easy to get the end result with a really positive one. We need to try. We need to learn from our mistakes, right? On a single shot, we cannot get the success. It takes time. This is an example of product innovation. And coming to product innovation, like definitely when you have some innovate, like we can take an example of bulb as well, or the mobile phones that we use, or the smartphones, or the tablets, or the TVs. Like all have been like very compact, right? Like very handy to carry now. Like earlier, the telephones, we need to carry that, right? It was very huge and it was not portable. Now all things are being portable, very easy and pocket friendly as well. That is the one thing, advantages of product innovation. Any other examples we can take here, apart from those which I mentioned? Like we can take an example of automobile itself. Like earlier it was not so efficient. Now over a period of time, we are now getting a fuel efficiency of nearly 25 kilometers per liter for an automobile. Very good, right? But when you look into the product innovation, there will be definitely an obviously and damn change in the design. Because the R&D team will be, research and development team will be working on that. They want that to be done in the best fashion. But why it will be done? The product innovation. It's so necessary to make an innovation in a product. What is required for any organization? It is, yes or no, guys? Or what do you think? Is it so necessary to survive? Or can we survive without innovative ideas? Do you think it's possible that we will not take up some innovative steps from now on? Let's see how it goes. Is it possible to do like that? No, right? We should be definitely having some steps because of the customer's need and demand. There will be development of new products. That is the thing. That is why product innovation will be coming to picture. Just, I'm sorry, guys. And coming back to the product innovation, like there will be some, we cannot say that every product will be all the same. Change, there will be some important changes, right? The degree of the change will also will be different. Like there will be a what you can say, earlier CFS was produced but not so efficient, but there will be some incremental improvements, right? When you come to the product innovative ideas, there will be an the incremental improvement on a daily basis, or not on the daily basis, at least when they come up with some new product. When any organization, let us take an example of a bulb or a CFS itself, when they come up with some innovation or when they come with a new product, at least let us say half year or yearly basis, there will be some improvements, right, in their product, that with what they have bought. It will be more efficient and it will be having some new products also. They will be developing some new products as well, right? That is the one more thing. And some of the examples for product innovation, the example that we can like really familiar for all of us, like the TV. Earlier what you can see is like the TV screen size was relatively big. We can take the same example for the computers as well. Like now the innovative ideas have made laptops, tablets, really we can carry them. Yes or no? That is the power of innovation. Creative ideas. If you are having those set of skills, you can survive. That's the matter. And changing from a cathode ray tube TV to a flat TV, the same thing.
And now the recent advancement is not the recent one, like around 6 to 7 years ago. Internet access to TVs is also available. That is the one more thing that what we can say. And coming back to the product innovation. Like, why are they doing the product innovation? Is it so required for the organizations to survive? Or let us take an example. If you are not taking an for our career itself, if you are not taking the initiatives or some creative ideas, we are not looking into our career itself. We'll be like surviving for a longer period of time. Or no, right? We need to improve ourselves. We need to make our efficiency, our set of skills more, right? We want to improve the daily basis in the same way. Innovating or innovative ideas or the innovation helps to increase the efficiency as well as they'll be developing it with more effective purpose. Efficiency will increase and it will be user-friendly one. How user-friendly? How it will be user-friendly? Like, rather, let us take an example of the cell phones or the telephones. Like earlier, it was not portable to carry, but now we can carry that a very easy way. Is it user friendly or not? Yes or no? And now they last longer when they charge for 100%. We are having that larger capacity, like larger what you can say, screen time, or its efficiency is increased. We can use it for like 8 hours, 10 hours. That is an add-on advantage that is user friendly. And it's really valuable. Anyone can say that the mobiles, if you use according to a requirement, no product will be like not valuable. It depends on us how we utilize that, how we utilize the resources. Solely depends on us. Okay. Any doubts till now? Like, we need to discuss the process innovation as well as the service innovation. Any doubts so that we can have a discussion. Okay, and coming to the next thing is the process innovation. What do you mean by the process innovation? Why it is required? The same way, right? Like, the process itself refers that certain steps will be taken or the new inputs will be added to bring out a better product. That is what it refers as the process innovation. Like, there will be a set of activities, there will be an overall change in the design, the inputs will be given by different, and the output will be for the benefit of the customers. What we can say? We'll take an example so that we can easily relate here. Let us take an example of any automobile sector, or like automobile sector itself will take a very clear, it will be very easy for you to understand. I think all of you know about Maruti Suzuki, the best, or the having the highest sales figure. Having the highest sales, it provides really good services. Like, there was a demand from the customers of Maruti saying that we want a better automobile with more safety features, and then Maruti looked into their process. They came with some innovative ideas. They looked in and they implemented the airbags, bought into that, gave them the more recent technologies, advancement sensors, that was, and they used a new different process for that output of the particular automobile. I'll take an example of Berlino, which is equipped with the most recent features. Like, they have a different procedure to produce that, and the output will be like really beneficial for the customers. That is why process innovation is required. And coming back to the process innovation, why it is required? Like, it makes it simpler. Like, if you are setting up it, like when you have the clear cut idea that what we need to do, it will be really simpler for us. Yes or no? If they have set, if they set the what you can say, the CNC and all for the production of a particular set of commodity itself, it will be really simpler. It will be like when you are having the design in a very efficient way, it makes us life simpler, right? and it will be like we can produce it at a faster rate, more accurate, more reliable, and less expensive. How? How would it be less expensive? Because we have set up a separate plant. We have taken an example of Bolano itself. There are certain set of CNC that are solely kept for the production of Bolano itself. When you are keeping that aside for only one particular thing, it will be like producing without any break in between, and it will produce a more number of products at a lesser number of time. And when you have the best or the new set of innovative ideas that have been implemented, creative idea that we have taken, and the design of that is really damn good, the end will be like we will get up a more efficient product, more accurate one, and which will be like really cost friendly as well, and the overall production capacity and the overall product that will be produced in a period of or a span of time will be really more. That is another advantage that we will be getting from the process innovation. Any doubts? For having innovation skills or innovative skills between innovation as well as invention. Innovation and invention. And like what are the different types of innovation? How innovations are in different aspects? What are the different types of innovation? All the things we already discussion, right? Any doubts? And coming back to the service innovation, the third type of innovation. What do you understand by this current slide or the pictorial representation that has been represented here? Like each and every one, every organization, when you take an example, will be having its own set of clients. Or is there any organization without any clients? Or is it possible? No, right? They will be having their own set of clients. And those clients will be providing a service for the customers. In turn, or the last. And there will be a practice, right? For the customer, they will be having some new set of things. They want some, they will be having the regular practice. They want some time of them to be saved, time of their daily life. Should be saved, and then you as an organization will look into how we can improve those type of, like when you take an example of an automobile or a cell phone, you want some improvements, right? The client if asks them that we want a better product from your end, you may look into the improvements, but how you need to improve. They will give you an order that you want to improve. I want a better product from your end. How will you deal with that? How will you deal? How will you improve? Is it so easy? How will you improve that? And it should be not, and they will also give a other important note is like it should be reliable as it should be like really better one. And you need to come up with a solution. You as an organization, you should be, if you need to come up for a solution for these set of things, you should be having that is the solution. How will you do that? The client has said all those things and they require a really damn good commodity at the end, but you need to satisfy all these conditions. It should be really an improved version. It should be real. It should be like having a longer life. You need to develop a solution. How will you achieve that? By the technologies, by some innovative ideas, some creative ideas, somehow achieve this. And so in turn of the innovative or the creative ideas that what you had made, the overall efficiency will be increased. That is will be the end result of any innovation or innovative ideas. And the client will be satisfied. In turn, the customers will also be really, what I can say, be really happy. as I mentioned earlier, like service innovation involves where they would like to improve its reliability, like a longer period of life, like how they can use it over a longer period of time, or it's only applicable for a short of period of time. Like the service industries are those, like we can relate that to our food, education, they need to improve on a daily basis, transport, health, they be like working, and how we can improve, how we can increase the efficiency, how we can improve the efficiency, or the, what I can say, there will be some date of expiry, right, for any product if you are buying a food commodity. While service industries want that food to be stored for a longer period of time, they need to have some ideas, right? They need to come up with some creative things to improve those. And in turn, the customers, we as customers would also want the same. We want to keep the storage of some particular product for a longer period of time, or a food commodity. It will be really helpful for us and we will be benefited. That is the thing that is will be like service innovation. Like a service innovation, obviously they'll be looking at how they need to implement the technology, how they can provide a better service. And now, because of the use of the technology, the internet and all, the scope of the service industry has increased a lot. Like they are like really satisfying the customer's demand on a daily basis in a very effective way. By those things, they are having the customers in turn are getting the better service, as well as the technology, the updated features. They can even purchase the commodities that are required on a daily basis on the online, their fingertips. That's the advantages of innovation. Any doubts till now? And these are the different types of innovations in depth, like the product process, all of those things that have been already said for you. And there will be like organization innovation, management innovation, production innovation, like product and the production means the steps that they will take. They will mention it in a very precise way. That is what it refers as production innovation. And the commercial as well as service at the end. These are the different types when you look into the deeper side. Any doubts regarding any of the topics that has been covered? Because we are looking at the last stage of any creative idea. And coming back to the phases, any other term for the phases? You can relate it to any other example. What do you mean by the term phases? Very easy one. Like the steps or the procedure that we need to follow. That is what it refers as phases of innovation. There will be two phases when you are looking up to come up with a new product or a new idea for a particular commodity. You need to definitely have a design right from your end, or by, if I am thinking that I am having an innovative idea that I want to produce a commodity X. But I should have some visualization, right? How it should look from the previous. We cannot give the same design and say that we have innovated something or we have implemented a new design. We need to have some different unique design. And we need to implement, right? Just by designing, we cannot reach the customers or we cannot get the end result. It cannot benefit the mankind. So you should be having a definite design, as well as you should have that added. Implementation is also really important. This is a very crucial part. Like several times we might go wrong, or not so wrong, but we might not achieve the desired result at the first shot itself. That is what it refers, like what I say, like very difficult task, like to get the implemented in the first shot itself, but you can do that. Don't worry that if you are innovative idea is being not achieved on the first shot itself, we will be definitely achieving that. But just look into, don't try to give up. That's the important thing that you need to have from your end. The design phase, what you'll be doing? What do you think is really important when you're designing? How will you design? Like, you will take into suggestion, like, if you're, you should be having some really different, unique thinking and creativity. That is the one first and the foremost thing. And if sometimes you can get some ideas from your fellow mates, from the teammates, or who are working for the particular project, and you can get the idea from the research papers, all those things you should have a look right before designing. Or you would like to go with, or and you should also have a look whether the customers, you should have a point of view or what kind of thinking attitude in the point of a customer, according to a customer, getting in the shoes of the customer, that what you can say, thinking as a customer, how would you like the design should be? Yes or no? That is the one thing. And in the implementation stage, like, we have already a plan and we are now trying to implement that, we should manage all those things. We need to get the satisfied work at the end. And here we need to sometimes the design that what you have thought during the implementation, we need to change, right? Some of the things that we need to rectify when you go to the production, or what you can say, the implementation phase, we feel that it would be better. Those corrections, those things, on the, and when you produce a product for the first time, obviously there will be some errors, but the second time we need to evaluate that entire thing, the innovative product that we have brought up, looked into that, and you need to come with a better one, right? That should be like really important after implementation. Any doubts? Okay. An implementation process, like, we need to have an incremental innovation in the same. Like, when any organization comes up with a new product initially, they definitely to be like working on that and bringing up a better model in a period of like 2 or 3 months. Like, they will look in the negatives and they will make it more like with better, and they will leave not so much risk involved. Why? Because any organization is coming up with an innovative product, it will just prepare like initial, like what you can say, a selected number of pieces itself. When the demand is there, when the demand grows again, they will look into that and they again produce that. That is why there will be not of so risk will be involved. That is the one thing. But reaching that end stage is very difficult. If you have that set of ideas and innovative skills, you can definitely achieve that. I will paste the attendance and the feedback form in the meantime, and we'll get back to the same slide because we need some time to fill that, right? I'll get back to the same slide. Please fill both the forms, very required, very much required. Please fill both the attendance as well as the feedback form. Please fill both the forms. Okay. And coming to the next thing, like, what will be the advantages of all those innovative ideas that you bring up? There will be definitely be contributing from future And the future growth of any innovative idea that we bring up, we are now like the SpaceX Foundation, the only private organization for space, is like having some innovative ideas, right? They are trying to make a community on the moon. That is an innovative idea that they are doing. They are thinking of, never know. But it is for the betterment of mankind. That is the one thing. And to improve the market, nice. That is the one more thing. And when you are doing, or when you are coming with some innovative ideas of any particular product, obviously the end result will be, it will be more efficient. Is there, you know? There is the one more thing. The efficiency and the quality on the, what we can say, on the life cycle, the life of the particular essential, or that requirement will be really high. This life cycle will be more, it will be like more durable, better for use, user friendly. All those things will be getting it as an added advantage. And when you are doing all those things, there will be definitely a profit, right? When you are the customer's desires or the needs are met, obviously the end result will be really the best one. These are some of the advantages of innovation. Any doubts till now? Okay, I will just give an overview that what are things that we had discussed till now. We looked into definition of innovation. What is innovation in a precise way? Like the creativity and accepting the failures that we had gone, we have discussed that, and how we will come up with the innovations. Like we'll come up with the innovative products, there will be different process for that, and a new market will be definitely be there. And what is the difference between innovation and invention? And how inventions are being now made commercial use by having some, adding some of the innovative ideas to their particular inventions, how they are being commercialized. And we looked into the what different types of innovation, the product innovation, process innovation, and the service innovation. Product, obviously, got to know where the design. Efficiency will be increased there. That is one important. How we can take us for the betterment of your academics, like mind mapping. I gave an example like how to like refer for any of the particular subject. Make a note of that. Got to know that. And how service innovation, how you should be capable of giving some creative ideas, that we got to know, right? And we had a look at different types, like in like there were nearly like 7 types of different innovations. And when you look into some innovations, definitely we need to have different steps, right? We cannot just think and idealize that I thought for an innovation, now it will go. You should be having some design as well as the attitude to implement that. And how we need to do that, how we need to improve when you are innovating something. All those things we had a discussion. And thank you for the patient listening. For any doubts? Any doubts till now? Okay, guys, we'll wind up the session. Thank you for the patient listening for the past 1 hour.